We're working on muscle stem cells in the embryo and in the adult. And one of the difficulties in working with stem cell populations, in many stem cell populations, is trying to identify how the fate of that cell is regulated as soon as you try to manipulate it. And the challenge is trying to look at that fate in vivo. And one of the components of the stem cell, a microenvironment, is the niche, which is composed of multiple types of proteins that are secreted and interacting with the stem cell and interacting with the, in the case of skeletal muscle, with the fiber that the stem cell is sitting on. So what we have done is try to create an artificial niche in vitro by using micropattern technologies in the collaboration with Manuel Terry in France. And so basically, in two words, what happens here is we create a small environment on which we can put individual stem cells, and then we manipulate the environment and the geometry of the environment to ask if the fate of that cell is being changed or not. And in fact, our results show that the fate of the cells is being changed when we change the small, make small changes in the microenvironment of the cell, the topology and the cell adhesion properties of the micropatterns. So this is telling us that extrinsic cues coming from the microenvironment are very important in regulating the stem cell, but obviously once those extrinsic cues are relayed, there are other mechanisms that take over inside the cell, intrinsic cues that lead to the progressive cell fate. So by looking at individual cells, symmetric, asymmetric cell divisions, and reconstituting the niche, we hope to understand a little bit about stem cell biology, especially when you take these cells and transplant them, and the niche itself is destroyed or altered, and that could be affecting the properties of the stem cells.